Hi everyone, this is Sunny Kumar from IIT BHU and welcome to my channel Code with Sunny. And today I am going to discuss the problem maximum frequency stack of lead code. Index number is 895 and the problem is of hard type. Okay, so let's jump directly into the problem statement. We have been given a class frequency stack and which simulates the operation of a stack like data structure. Okay, it has two member functions. Push, which pushes an integer x into the stack, and pop, which removes and returns the most frequent element in the stack. Okay, so if there is a type of most frequent element, the element closest to the top of the stack is removed and returned. Okay, so basically at a certain instant of time, at a certain moment, if we have to perform the pop operation, then we have to return the most frequent element, that is the element having maximum frequency in the current state of the stack, and we have to remove that and we have to return. And if there are two or more elements having the same frequency, then that element is returned which is closest to the top of the stack. Okay, now here are certain set of examples. I'm going to discuss that also. Let's move to the constraints. Frequency calls will not exceed 10,000 and it is also 10,000 and it will not exceed sum of all will 15,000. Okay, so how we are going to do this problem and what will be our approach? Let's move further. So what is actually basically given in this question? Given a sequence of pushed element and pop operations of the stack, and pop operation will return the element having maximum frequency in the stack, and if elements have the same frequency, return the elements closest to the top of the stack. Okay, so what will be our main goal? That is, we have to use an efficient data structure to implement push and pop operations efficiently. So how I am going to do this? Let's discuss with examples. So before proceeding further, I recommend, or you can say, I am going to tell you what I have actually used the two data structure, or you can see the two useful STL functions that I am going to tell you. I am going to maintain you can say, or I'm writing, maintain a hash table. Okay, hash table of what's elements and its frequency. So now one thing our viewers will think, why I'm going to use the hash table to maintain the elements and its frequency? This is because we all know that in this problem we must know the frequency of element at any time to process and to give the answer and to update the answer. So we have to maintain a hash table of elements and its frequency. And another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to maintain a maximum frequency, or you can say I'm going to maintain a maximum frequency variable. Why I'm going to use this maximum frequency variable? Because it will state what is the current maximum frequency at any time and which element is going to hold that maximum frequency. So also I am going to maintain what you can say, a mapping of frequency to the what stack. What why I am going to use this mapping of frequency of stacks? This will denote, I am going to write, it will denote that which element has reached this frequency and in which order. That is, you can say, suppose I have what MP of let's say 1 dot to insert, or you can say I have a stack, so I'm going to push up. So if MP of 1 dot push X is a statement and another MP of 1 dot push X push Y will be a statement, then it will denote for a frequency 1, first X has arrived, then Y has arrived. So if we have been asked that suppose I have a maximum frequency of 1, and if we have been asked what is the pop operation result, then we have to print Y, because in pop operation we have to return the element that is closest to the stack if two or more elements having the same frequency as of maximum frequency. Because Y is closest to the top, so I'm going to return Y, then return X. Okay, so this is how I'm going to do that. So let's discuss the examples. Now initially I have an empty stack. Now I have to push 5, then 5 frequency will become 1 in frequency table, and now correspondingly in the mapping of frequency to the stack, for the frequency 1, first 5 has reached, so I'm going to push 5 for this case, and now I have to push 7. So I have the frequency table updated at this one, and I have a 7 which will be updated like whose frequency is 1. So what would be our new mapping of frequency of stack? Note that for the frequency 1, 5 has already been reached. Now 7 is reached, so a 7 is placed after 5. Now you can see again I have what 5 is pushed now, so 5 frequency will become 2. And what about 7's frequency? It will still remain as 1. Okay, so it will still remain as 1. And so what would be our new mapping of frequency of stack? Note that in for the frequency of 1, 5 has reached first, then 7 has reached. Now you can say for the frequency 2, now you can see 5 has reached now. So I'm going to update this one actually. So for similar operations, now you can see 7 is going to be what? 7 is pushed, so 7th frequency will become 2. Now for the mapping of frequency of stack, so I am going to push 7 now for the frequency 2, you can see here. Now again 4 is pushed, so I am going to write my new line. So now if 4 is pushed, in previously I have this one, these two frequency tables, okay, and now 4 is pushed. So I'm going to update 4's frequency as 1. So what would be my new updated this mapping of stack? So for the frequency 1, 5 has reached first, then 7 has reached, then 4 has reached now. Okay. So I have again second as what? 5 and then 7 and then what? Then 1, then that's it. Now now at finally I am going to push 5, because there are 6 push operations. Now I have still done 5, so I'm going to push 5. Note that 5 frequency will become 3. And what about this will going to be updated as for the frequency of 3, I have the only first element that has reached is 5. Okay, so what is the maximum frequency after a sequence of the what push operations? It would be what? Current maximum frequency is what? 3. Now I have to perform the pop operations. So how I am going to perform the pop operation efficiently? Now for the pop operation, let me fetch the current maximum, which is 3. And if the current maximum is 3, I have to pop out the element whose frequency is going to match with the current maximum, and that element is going to be closest to the top of the stack. So how we can get this? So we are going to look into the mapping of frequency to the stack. And if you look into this, you can see 3 for frequency 3, the element that is closest to the top is 5. So our answer would for the first popping operation is 5. And if 5 has been popped, if its frequency will be what? Frequency of 5 is going to be what? Reduced by 1. And if frequency of 5 is going to be reduced by 1, then what would be our new frequency? You can see if 5's frequency is going to be reduced by 1, I'm going to raise it and make it 2. And now you can see this 5 is consumed, so I'm going to erase this. So what would be our new maximum frequency, that is current maximum frequency now, if at any instant of time, if mapping of mapping of frequency to the stack is going to be, its size is going to be reduced by 1, or you can see it is that stack, or you can say any of the stack is going to be consumed completely, you can see our maximum frequency changes to what? 2. Here you can see. So now for now I have a maximum frequency of what? You can see I have a current maximum of 2, because it is going to be decreased by 1. And if our current maximum is 2, I am going to check which element is going to be the nearest to the top of the stack, and its frequency is exactly same as what the maximum frequency now, that is 2. I'm going to fetch in the mapping of frequency to the stack, and we can see 7 is closest to that, so I'm going to erase 7. And if I erase 7, I'm going to reduce its frequency by 1. And if 7's frequency is reduced by 1, our answer is what? 7. And can the maximum frequency, that is current maximum, is going to change or not? No, it is not going to change because it still have a single element 5 left in that stack. I'm not going to change this. So now again I have a current maximum of what? Again 2. And what would be our answer in this case? 5, because 5 is it nearest to the top. And can the current maximum is going to change for the next one? Yes, it is going to change because it will be erased. So our new current maximum will become 1. And what would be our new updated? This note that 5 is consumed. Also, I am going to erase this one. So similarly, you can perform the sequence of operation and fetch to the result. So let's discuss the approach. Note that I am going to use the maps that is going to handle the sequence of push and pop operations efficiently. Note that there are only two maps that is going to be sufficient to solve this problem in most efficient manner. So how we are going to do this? Let's discuss the approach. Create a frequency table using maps element to the frequency. Maintain a current maximum variable. Also create a stack of frequency, that is stack which tells at that particular frequency. Here are the list of elements arrived in order. In a push operation, I am going to mainly focus on three things. Increment the frequency of the element in the frequency table. Update the current maximum variable if possible. If my new frequency is going to be what, more than the maximum frequency, I'm going to update the maximum frequency as obvious. Now I'm going to push the entry into the map of stacks, and that is this element reached this frequency. Now similar to this case, like let's suppose I'm going to push 4 now. So if I'm going to push 4 now, it will denote that for frequency equal to 1, 4 has reached its frequency 1. So I'm going to update this in this stack, that is 4 is going to be pushed to the this stack of frequency equal to 1. Okay, now in a pop operation, I am going to perform or focus on three things mainly. That is, maximum frequency element should be popped out. So how can we fetch it directly? That is in using the map of frequency to the stack. So pop the maximum frequency element, and after popping we have to check if maximum frequency variable needs to be updated or not. When it should be updated, the maximum frequency variable will be updated or will be decreased by 1 only and only when the stack that is we are working upon now, the frequency that is mapping of frequency to the stack we are working upon now, is going to be exhausted completely. Then we are going to reduce my maximum frequency variable by 1. And we are going to update accordingly maximum frequency variable. So this is the basic approach. Let's discuss the approach, or you can say discuss the code. Okay, I have a current maximum frequency here, you can see, and the mapping on a dot map I have used for first operations. Okay, now I have a map frequency table here, another frequency table, or you can say int to the stack of int, mapping of frequency to the stack. That is, this frequency, for a particular frequency, what are the elements that have reached in order? Now I have a push method. I'm going to increment my frequency and update my current maximum if possible, and store in the stack that this element has reached this frequency now. That is, you can see I have a store map, unordered map, frequency of x dot push x. Okay, now I have a pop method. And now I'm going to fetch my answer, that is store of current maximum dot top, that is the top of the element that is closest to the current stack state of top. Now I'm going to pop out that element, this is no longer useful. Now I'm going to check if current maximum needs to be updated or not. So if I check if that current maximum frequency can be affected by decreasing that element, or you can say by removing that element. So if that stack is going to be empty, our current maximum needs to be updated. Finally, I'm going to return the answer for the pop operation. So let me submit this code and check out if this is going to be best possible answer or not. Yes. Okay, so if you have any doubts, do not forget to mention in the comment section of the video. And I will ask the viewers to like this video, share this video, and do subscribe to my YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you for watching this video.